Thank you all for coming today. I'll try to keep this relatively short. We have a long list of issues that we hope will be addressed this upcoming session. We stand ready to work with Speaker Lecter, Speaker Deal on some of these issues. Our state can no longer afford to stick our head in the sand and defend it. Real problems dealing with racial injustice no longer exist. Some of our issues that we've championed for years are coming to a head. Ethics reform being at the top of that list. Ethics in the state has gotten so bad, public perception so bad, that finally Republicans can no longer pretend that there is no need for ethics reform in the General Assembly. We are glad that they're finally recognizing that some of these things need to be fixed, and we hope to interject some of our own ideas and reforms that will be taking place. While it obviously doesn't seem to be a priority for the majority, we will continue to push for Medicaid expansion. At some point, it just becomes completely unreasonable, the decision not to expand Medicaid when both Democratic and Republican states are expanding our healthcare systems throughout the country. We will continue to support legislation that protects Missouri workers and their families. And finally, dealing with issues related to Ferguson that touch many aspects of state government. Sweeping changes need to be made to begin to right some of the institutionalized injustice that has led to a system that hurts those at the bottom of the economic spectrum. Each day it makes it harder and harder to dig yourself out of the hole. So with that, I'll be happy to take any questions.
Could you enumerate what you mean by sweeping changes that need to be made?
Absolutely. So we've created some working groups that are working on what we're going to call four pillars of reform. Some dealing with economic issues, some dealing with obviously court reform, social justice issues, and so on. Those are not completed yet. We don't want to just throw out legislation. We want to take some input from some of our members. You know, House Democrats represent those districts that are most directly affected, and we hope that the majority will listen to some of our ideas. These are problems that, you know, I know that Senator Schmidt has proposed some municipal court reform. They're certainly very supportive of some of those issues. We're going to be very happy to work with both sides of the aisle here to get some of this stuff done. We just hope to listen to some of our priorities.
So when do you expect to have actual bills?
Yes, we will. We will have some. Probably within the next week or so, we'll be filing them. I think it's important to realize that this isn't just one or two different issues. Unemployment in the state may be on the downswing of 6%, but unemployment among the African American community remains above 10% in the single metropolitan area. We have a court system that somewhat buries people in fines, just trying to keep those court systems up to pay for more police, to pay for more issues in communities that have shrunk demographically, they've shrunk in population, and they're trying to maintain duplicated layers of government. And perhaps some of those forms of, there has to be some form of consolidation. And I know that's very problematic, even for members of my own caucus, to begin to talk about that. It's very painful. But it's something that I think needs to be done and needs to be addressed. We can't talk about systematic change in government, St. Louis County, St. Louis City government without some form of consolidation on some municipalities, perhaps even fire districts or police districts. Yes, sir.
Is there anything that you all as Democrats can do to ensure that the African or minority community can get better jobs or be trained without having to go all the way to Hannibal, Missouri to be trained for certain jobs? Is there anything that can be done for that? Because I know right now a lot of your training areas are in Hannibal and the outstate St. Louis, and the people that need the jobs that are not working cannot get that far unless someone support them taking them that far. Is anything can be done for that?
Absolutely. I think there's things that we can look at expanding, especially in community colleges in North County. I know that Boeing partners with community colleges there to begin to have training in the aerospace industry. And with Boeing creating another 2,000 jobs or a grand combination of 2,000 jobs in, I think it's important to look at expanding those programs. I know that it's currently in the works. Dealing back to last year's special session, the Boeing bill, and so that's stuff we are looking to expand on.
Okay.
Job creation in some of those
for minorities.
Absolutely.
Okay.
With your diminished numbers, what can you really accomplish in this legislative session?
Well, you know, Rudy, I think if you went back and asked Speaker Griffin how easy it was to govern with 110 some odd Democrats, he'd tell you that probably the problem wasn't dealing with the minority, it was dealing with factions from his own caucus. And so I think that if the caucus is large as the Republicans have, it's probably going to be problematic at some point to control all of those different factions and interests. And we're happy to work with whatever group is going to help us move our legislation forward. And I will be the first one to say that we're very willing to work with Speaker Deal. I know that there's going to be economic development issues that we're going to all be able to work together. We all want to create jobs. We don't always have the same ideas on how to do it, but we're going to try.
I've heard from Democratic leaders over the last several sessions talk about the importance of a cooperative system, a bipartisan system. And I've also seen the numbers diminish every session since I have been covering since 2011. Are you doing the same thing and expecting a different result?
No, first of all, I would say that things weren't exactly bipartisan last year, maybe on certain bills, but I think that it was fairly contentious. I can directly relate our loss of legislative seats to the lifting of campaign donation limits, if we wanted to go back that far. So this year when we talk about ethics reform, I think it's important to talk about what really needs to happen with ethics reform. Certainly I think the lobbyist expenditures need to be addressed, but let's face it, you have one individual in the state of Missouri that seems to be buying elections, and I think it's time to change that.
You're a St. Louis guy. How important is it to keep the Rams in St. Louis, and how far should the state go to do it?
Well, that's the $700 million question, isn't it? Certainly, St. Louis is an NFL team. I recognize the need to keep the Rams there. Is it to the tune of taxpayer dollars? I think it's been proven that perhaps there's other ways to go about that. I think if you ask Stan Kroenke, he's not planning on using any taxpayer dollars in Los Angeles. And so perhaps there's other ways that we can invest, whether it's bonds that directly are paid back by ticket tax or some other way to help fund a new stadium. Certainly it's problematic at best that we still have, I believe, about 7 more years to repay the bonds from the first stadium. So there's going to be that possibility that stadium in downtown St. Louis is empty. Our state taxpayers are on the hook for the next few years. And so whatever we do, I think it's important to lock down a long-term lease if we're so lucky to keep the Rams here, to make sure that that's not an issue for future legislatures to deal with.
Do you see any convergence of the issues raised by Ferguson with the Medicaid expansion issue? And is that at all helpful to Medicaid?
Does that help move Medicaid forward? I can't answer that. I would have to ask the speaker that. When you look at all of the social issues that affect the issues that have led up to FERS, it's not one thing. But with chronic unemployment, with the lack of access to health care, these things add up. They create tension, they keep people stuck in a cycle where they cannot lift themselves out. And so I think that is a huge step forward. That would be something that would be absolutely helpful to the residents of Ferguson begin to help us heal. Whether that happens or not, I can't answer that. Anybody else? Okay, next.